Transformation Tuesday. So we have another amazing success story. You're looking at a before photo of Dr. Mike Stachniak, a local psychiatrist who reached out to St. Louis's go-to weight loss coach, Charles D'Angelo. And drum roll, please. Here he is now, 65 pounds lighter. Mike, you look incredible. Please take a seat. Thank you so much for joining us today.
Thank you for having me.
Okay, so we have to ask, everyone wants to know the secret here. What was it about Charles that just worked for you?
You know, as a psychiatrist, I think the first time I met Charles, I realized that his program was different. Rather than just talking about the poor food choices I was making and lack of exercise, he really got into the psychology of, you know, me using food as a crutch, and especially during stressful times in my life. And really, it was that, you know, approach. As a shrink, I had to take a step back and say, who's on the couch right now?
Yeah. You know?
But it's what worked for me. It worked very well.
And what have you seen change in your life now, 65 pounds lighter?
I feel differently about food, about exercise. Yeah. You know, it's just a different level of motivation, a different approach. The accountability in Charles' program is huge. I think that's really what kept me on track and successful.
Yeah, and what made you first even want to pick up the phone and call Charles?
Yeah, I'd done a number of different weight loss programs and workout routines and was always frustrated with the lack of results over time. And so I think just, you know, hearing about this program from other fellow physicians who'd done very well in the program, I decided to give it a shot, and it's the best decision I've made in a long time.
Oh, wow. I mean, Charles, how does it sound to hear that? How rewarding of a thing. But first, why don't we talk with you about, you always talk about how it's a holistic approach. Mm-hmm. You know, this is not just about the physical body, and I think Mike's a huge testament to that.
So many different approaches take a very siloed approach to change. Mm-hmm. So a lot of people approach this as if food is the most important. The primary focus. And while it is important, another aspect is obviously exercise. So you could go to a dietitian or nutritionist and they'll say that it's the most important thing, food. Yeah. The second person, a trainer, an exercise physiologist will say, you know, well, if exercise isn't in there, that's really what's most important. Food's important. And how you think's important is something that really matters too, but exercise is where it's at. And then you might go to someone who's a professional in terms of mental health and they'll talk about the importance of understanding yourself in psychology. I found that you have to have all three of those gears, healthy food, routine exercise, and then an understanding of yourself and mindset. Those three gears have to be working together to make the machine of change actually happen. So when I work with people, we don't take a siloed approach. Certainly people know exactly what to eat. I tell them exactly what to do, when to do it, down to the brands. So if a person has no experience, no understanding of healthy eating, they will learn that. If they've never worked out, they'll also start to integrate a healthy exercise routine, starting with just walking. But really what separates my approach, as Mike said, from everything else out there is understanding the mindset. Food is not just food for most people. In many of my clients' cases, it's kind of a quote-unquote treatment plan for feeling anxious or feeling afraid or feeling sad or celebrating. So it's really about learning how to disconnect from using food in that type of dysfunctional way.
Completely.
Cutting that cord, and then over time, once you reach a goal, learning how to reconnect with food so you're using it in a very appropriate and helpful way to keep yourself moving in the direction of health.
And that's what makes you different, right? It makes you different, and it makes this really a lifetime thing.
Well, I've been there. I was 360 pounds as a kid, so I lost 160 pounds 2 decades ago, and I know firsthand what it feels like to be stuck, but also what it takes to get to where you want to go, like Mike is.
Yeah, well, Mike, you look incredible. Congrats again. Now, if you're watching this and you're feeling inspired to start your own weight loss journey, reach out to Charles by calling the number right there on your screen.